Welcome back to AutoZone Pod for the inaugural championship of the Premier Rugby Sevens. This is Cup semi-final number two in the men's division. We just saw the Loggerheads defeat the team 26-12, and now the experts take on the headliners. And I'm Dallin Stanford, and speaking of experts, I've got Madison Hughes, Olympian, and Brianna Kemp next to me. Thoughts on this second game coming up?
It's going to be really interesting. Experts, two wins from two. Headliners did have that loss. The headliners did have loss to the team who we just saw lose their semi-final. So going to be really interesting. Experts probably have that balance. And that second performance from the experts really impressed me. They paired their attacking prowess with a strong defense.
Yeah, I think the experts have a ton of pace, and they've been lethal from all across the field. And the headliners stick out to me because they've got so much composure. They've been looking to leaders like Tim Stanfield to really set the tone and go forward. So two different styles of play here, and we're going to see how that shows down.
Headliners with Lucas Sheck, the Canadian Rocket, in picture. And Filiki Tonga ready for the experts. Naima Fualau, the 23-year-old with the US Sevens program, experience on the World Sevens Series, is ready to go. And so are we. Perry Baker, the Olympian, two times World Sevens Series Player of the Year, goes high and comes down to the headliners in pink and yellow.
Advantage over.
Early drive from them. Good strong carry.
Blue, get out.
They take it up. Nick Boyer. Fan support. Boyer, a little half gap. Crawl the scrum off. Flicks it back in field. Juggled. There'll be no Vegas show line for him at all. Pete Tiberio.
Boyer did really well. He's a scrum half in 15s, but he's big and he's fast. And it really shows well in the sevens pitch. And he put Tiberio in space, just not able to catch the ball, and Tiberio perhaps looked up, saw 50 meters in front of him, was wondering whether his hamstring still had it in him, but he's got the pace, but disappointed for the headlines.
Perry Baker in picture, all smiles. His teammate Carlin Isles hurt his back earlier this week, so wasn't able to take him on himself. They were looking forward to a foot race, going head to head. Fuller puts a kick in. Baker, not the best looking kick. Has it come off a opposition player? No.
And they will take it back to the lineup. But Folau, just disappointed with the execution. Nice little clean ball off of the scrum. They knew exactly what was happening, but instead of kicking it straight forward, it was just too much in the corner and no chance for Perry Baker there.
Headliners come through the top. Stanford, good at the lineup. Boyer in midfield now. Drifts across field. Nick Boyer looks for a switch. Big contact on Lucas Sheck. And then all over this are the experts getting the penalty. Tapping to go, and as Corey Jones is a live wire, Corey Jones loves the dummies, finds Baker. Oh, great tackle. Canadian on American winger. Still here for the experts. Jones yet again. Anthony Wellmers was involved earlier, and now the little bust through. The experts go underneath the sticks. A vital score from them. Logan Targo.
Targo has been their primary try scorer so far today. Really strong ball carrier. He's difficult to bring down. Went low on him. Didn't maintain their feet. Chris Tarori there, just losing his feet, reaching out, and Targo's going to power through those sort of tackles.
Well, Targo, his hero is his older brother, Matty Targo, represented the U.S. Army, played football and rugby as well to the highest level. Well, he is a unit. Is Logan Targo, the 24 from American Samoa. His fourth try so far in this tournament puts his side up 7 points to nothing. It's a confident start from the experts.
Perry Baker just down in the corner. We're hoping he'll be able to continue. He's the sort of player we really want to watch. Looks like he's walking back now, so hopefully Perry's all good and we can look forward to some more good moments from him.
Yeah, a lot of rugby in one day for these players. They've trained all week, but nothing replicates match practice. Two pool games and now the semis. Cup final up next. The winner will face the Loggerheads, Kevon Williams' side.
And this is what's challenging about this event is, though it's a one-day event, which is very exciting for the fans, it's tough to play four games in a row with only maybe an hour, hour and a half between each game. It's very different for the World Series, as Madison, you well know.
It really is. Held up there is Pete Tiberio, being manhandled there, the headliner. Tiberio has been fantastic to watch, the 32-year-old veteran, and now lives in Nashville, Tennessee.
Yeah, it's always one of the worst places to be, is when you realize that you're being held up by three guys and your teammates are going to let you fight. And Pete Tamira gets a bit lucky there. He loses the ball, but his team will get it back because of a knock-on by the experts. But that's when your team is saying, we need you to fight right now, try and get us the ball back. But you do it for 30, 40 seconds, and you are exhausted.
3 minutes to go. Perfect opportunity for the headliners to strike here.
Give him room.
Set piece comes to Folau Niua. So good with ball in hand. Rips it back to the forwards. March their way upfield. Ball is spits loose. It stays with the headliners. The men in pink fighting. Still there on the ground. Stanford in to help out. Niua. Tiberio goes across. Nick Boyer. Boyer on Baker. Takes on two players. Sheck comes in. Just to reset things. The headliners. Inside their half. Little stab over the top. Not the best looking kick from Niua as well. It gives experts possession. And they can make you pay as they look to range up on the outside. Here they go. Hightower. Dave Hightower. The veteran comes through and scores a popular try for his side. No one chases him, and he'll get score number two in the Cup semi-finals.
I think what's impressed me so much about the experts this game is both of their tries have come from their hard work on defense. It hasn't quite been, you know, the usual attack that you see, but they were taking the headliners from side to side, not giving up anything, just making their one-on-one tackles and being physical. And eventually, after several phases, they were able to turn over that ball, and then Hightower was able to run it down the sideline. Again, just that composure from the experts' defense is what is giving them success.
And they showed a 7-up look there, which changes the picture. Teams get so familiar with what the defensive pictures are. So showing up the 7-up look means there's no real space in attack. Folau Niua looked for the kick on his less favored right foot. A poor kick by his standards, and that gave the experts the opportunity.
Naima Fualau has 12 other loving siblings, he says. What a huge family he comes from. He can probably enter a team here at the Premier Sevens. They're good enough. Here come the experts. Restart to the headliners, looking to bust out of their 22. Boyer again with Tiberio and Oliver Broom to operate. Stanford was electric in the first couple pool games. Gets it away to Gavin Diomore.
Off, blew out!
Diomore, man from Boston, with the Chula Vista now, gets the penalty.
And just upset with that breakdown work in the area, thought he had that ball, but this is a chance for the headliners now to gain territory. You know Neil is going to take that ball for touch, and let's see if they can gain possession and beat that composed experts defense that we just talked about.
Yeah, 20 seconds left. This is probably going to be the last play of the half, and the headliners would love to end it on a positive note for them. Two converted tries down puts them in a bit of a hole. So narrowing that just before the half would drastically change the halftime team talk and the outlook for the beginning of the second half.
Wait till that ball's
out. Let's see if they can get it to their 18-year-old speedster, Lucas Sheck from Cactus Lake. No, they can't. It comes down to the experts. Corey Jones to Perry Baker. Baker puts a kick for over the top. Baker is electric, but so is the Canadian Rocket. It's the American Rocket that wins this race. It's Perry Baker, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, and that's the development of Perry's play, adding that kick. It's something he and Carlin Isles have been working on repeatedly, and sometimes it will frustrate us in training. We're like, come on, guys, you really need to keep doing this. But it's moments like that where it really pays off. Putting in a perfect kick, he gets the great bounce, outpaces Sheck to the line, and that's a beautiful single-man try, solo try from Perry Baker.
I mean, really, Madison, this is what has made what has helped Perry become two-time World Player of the Year, as you mentioned. As a wing, it is extremely difficult to have those repeated 70-meter runs, and Perry just finishes it off with a nice kick.
That's halftime. Three converted tries, 21-0. The experts lead the headliners in the Men's Cup semifinal number two from Memphis, Tennessee. Olympian Perry Baker scored the third of three tries for his side, and the experts, his team, up 21-0 at the break here against the headliners. A big second half needed, and what is important for the headliners to come back?
They just need to go phase by phase. It starts with this first kickoff. They can retain possession, just keep the ball. Don't force anything. Don't make simple mistakes. But they need to get some passages of play going and put the experts under pressure.
Let's see if they can get their names in the history books and make the first ever cup final. The winner faces the Loggerheads later today here at AutoZone Park in our one-day extravaganza. Gone the 10 as
release, Corey, release.
Gavin Diomore jumps up for that one nicely off the restart. Tiberio gets it across field. Couple little stutter steps to Niua. Little stab through for Stanfield, but Baker's there. He read it really well, did Perry Baker. The experience of the legend himself. And now gets a one-handed flick to Folau is there. His Eagle teammate back to Baker. They're having fun in the sun here in Tennessee. And Perry Baker has liftoff in Memphis.
And you can tell that Perry Baker is just having a good time with that one, just kind of messing with the defense there. Again, it all started from the defense. Perry Baker sweeping on that ball from Niua, chipping through, just being able to see through and get that support. And of course, you see here on that replay, gets that ball back and then just takes off.
And it all came from the original defensive recovery by Perry Baker. The experts seem to be saying, you can kick on us, but we're going to back off fast guys to go get that ball. And it's so hard to beat Perry Baker on the turn. He is that fast. And then he connected really well, beat the first man. And when you've got a kick chase, it's often fragmented. If you can beat that first defender, you'll be into some space.
Yeah, and credit to Folau Niua, you know, that was a perfect kickoff for the headliners. They retained that ball, and then unfortunately, just that second kick didn't quite work out with them. And of course, Perry's on the sideline. Maybe they keep that in their playbook.
Perry goes to have a little rest. Love what he's doing as well with the young kids in San Diego, coaching the next generation of players at the Perry Baker Rugby Camps. If you're in the area, make sure you check that out by the legend himself. He's got two tries. He's side up 28-0 against the headliners. Top down. It will come the way of the side that's yet to score.
Nothing really has gone very right for the headliners so far. 28-0 is a daunting deficit to face with just under 5 minutes left. But they can pair a few quick tries together. We've seen deficits like this turn around in sevens. Not particularly often, but yeah, it was the unfortunate circumstances in the Olympics when a reasonably big deficit did get turned around. So it can happen. That was painful. So it's still all to play for.
Bind.
Memories set. From the Tokyo Olympic Games from Madison Hughes as Tiberio flicks it down. Niua wide to Sheck. Lucas Sheck, we know he can motor, the 18-year-old. Not a lot of space to operate, so he finds his captain. They reload again. Tim Stanford. Uli ball. Gavin Diomore. Diomore on the outside. Looking for where his support is. Flicks a beautiful ball. The headliners look to cut back in. Back on the front foot with Tibbs Tiberio. Folau, lovely passing. Looking to range up the middle. Brilliant stuff from the headliners. They will scorch through and get their first try here in the Cup semifinals.
And that's just a result of some beautiful, really simple team play. Of course, you saw the break down the right sideline. Just a really easy pin and pass to the right corner. Set up the breakdown when they needed to, and then send it out to the left sideline. Again, just taking advantage of the numbers, and that's the clean ball that the headliners needed to play all game. Unfortunately, it's coming a little too late here.
Yeah, and DJ Stewart finishing off, but the headliners will be ruined. They didn't get some of those passages of play going earlier. Didn't take any moments of particular individual brilliance, but some good team play, some good support play, and just stretching the defense width to width.
Short, clever kick from Folau Niua. Doesn't come his way, though. Experts will take possession.
Yeah, really clever play from Folau Niua there. He spotted that there was no expert defender right up on the 10. So he puts a little dribbler through. Probably had a little less pace than he would have wanted. He had to wait for the ball to get there. And that put his pass to Tiberio under a little bit of pressure. So well executed, but unfortunately not what they needed either.
This expert side coached by Justin Hundley, former USA Sevens player, and David Fee as well. Played at two Sevens World Cups and 115s. Niua just providing a nuisance at the breakdown. The experts went unbeaten in pool play. Here they come again. They just slide backwards. Still there on that far side. Tago on a run. Chasers are there. Cross covers coming as well. Could be a home run. The experts put the icing on the cake.
Just a bit of a dagger there by the experts. You see that by the body language of the headliners, they're just gutted that they couldn't turn anything out of that, turn anything from that attack. Unfortunately, experts just running away with the ball and just making it look a little bit too easy right now.
Targo with yet another long-range try. He's one who's really impressed me today from the emerging group who stepped up. And he's scoring tries for fun for this experts team.
Logan Targo certainly is, played in the NFL. Utah Warriors MLR 2021 out of Washington State University, a name for the future. Well, that's what one of the goals of this tournament is, to unearth those gems. Confident into the cup final. They will face the Loggerheads later today. We have our women's bronze medal match, then the men's bronze, followed by the two cup finals as well. So a lot still to come here in Memphis, Tennessee. Danny Thomas is on the field, known as Tiny Dancer, out of Belmont Shore and UCLA. For the experts, Stanford provides a bit of pressure. The headliners look to come back on that far side. Strong fend again from Stewart. It's been a real nuisance. They go quickly though to the experts. A canoe cut through one more time. Lovely little ranging run still going through. And that's a fantastic solo effort. It's scored by Jake Klingelsmith, the 23-year-old. Wow, what a statement.
And again, just the experts showing that they don't want to let the foot off the pedal in this game, even though they're so far ahead. They want to put all the points on, show the other teams that they are not messing around, even with the impact subs coming in. Just that quick tap from Danny Thomas set that up, and keeping the headliners on the back foot as they have all game. Yeah, the